Madeline Vandersloos on the trombone. Welcome, everybody, to our final concert of the year. Welcome to the Triffo. Welcome back to live music, which is so cool. My name is Raymond Baril. I have the distinct pleasure of being in front of this group of people and a lot, and for many years, but still brings me great pleasure to be here all the time. That first piece of music was called Red Letter Day. It was written by a man by the name of Antti Riesensen. And we this year did a sort of a collaborative project with the Metropolia University in Finland. We've had students who have gone there in the past, and they have students who come here. So we do a collaborative joint project in education. But what we decided to do this year was also share music. So on the very first concert of their season this year, they did a number of pieces that were written by our people and writers from Edmonton and the area and from our school. And then on this concert, we're featuring music from their library as well. So again, that was called Red Letter Day. This evening, we're going to be featuring also our special guests, the MacEwan Youth Jazz Orchestra, under the direction of Jared Grieve, and they're sitting right here, and they'll be coming up shortly. And the other thing that I want to say is that I've had the opportunity, I presented the idea of working with an individual in the group under a mentorship program, who then acts as the assistant director and looks after some of these sectional and rehearsal duties within the ensemble. So I would like you to please put your hands together and welcome to the stand, Alyssa Moores.
evening, everyone. It's nice to be here. Lots of faces, although they're really dark. My name is Alyssa Moores. I've had the opportunity, as Ray said, to mentor as a director. I want to be a band teacher someday. but right now, I get to stand in front of these lovely people. I played in the band all 4 years of my degree here, and then took a year off, and now I'm back, but in a little bit of a different way. This next piece is called Connections. It's by Patty Darling, and I thought it was really fitting due to our connection with Finland. I thought it was a cool title to incorporate into the set, so I hope you like it.
That featured on the trumpet, Theodore Lusky. Right, there. And on the guitar, Morgan Hanna. And the bearded wonder, James Coomer on drums. Every year we always have a vocalist who works with our group, and we're very fortunate to have great teachers in our vocal department, and who provide lots of opportunities for them to work on scatting and working with large ensembles and small ensembles. And please put your hands together and welcome to the stage Miranda Smith. Smith. We're going to play one more piece, and we're going to do a quick switch over to the MacEwan Youth Jazz Orchestra under the direction of Jared Grieve. Before we do that, we're going to play our last piece. It's called Rubble Rousers. Oh, by the way, if you go back out in the intermission, if you haven't done so, there's a little QR code on the window. That's how programs are nowadays. I'm having problems getting used to it. I like physical tactile things. But anyways, but if you want, you can find the program out there, and you can have it on your phone or your device, and that'll look after that for you. Next piece, as I said, is called Rebel Rousers. I always look for a really great saxophone solo feature. It's something that sort of pushes that section, and it's kind of like, you know, if you look at orchestras, it's kind of like the violin section of an orchestra, or if you look at a concert band, it's like the clarinet and flute section of a concert band. I don't know what is in a choir, but it doesn't matter. But in the big band, the saxophone section certainly looks after that responsibility and role of sort of being that lead section. If you're going to try, there are great solis that are written out there, but if you're going to find one, you got to find one that's actually written by a saxophonist himself. And this one is written by Don Menza, and it features on the tenor saxophone Jacob Rabuka, and it features on the guitar again Morgan Hanna, and it features on the trumpet Alyssa Moores, and also on the trumpet Liam McRory Wilson, pardon me. There you go. And I hope you enjoy it. This is, as I said, Rebel Rousers. Thank you very much, everybody. They're going to exit. The next group is going to come out. And just be patient for a couple minutes, and we'll be right back with you.
Hi, good evening, everyone. Thanks for being here. We feel really privileged that we get a chance to be a part of this evening tonight. Ray approached the band about a month ago and asked if we would like to share the bill and have a set and be guests here tonight. So we were chomping at the bit to play. It's been a while. So this is our second performance for this year. We have a couple more coming up. There's another one in 2 weeks here at MacEwan, across the hall in the Betty Andrews Recital Hall. And then we have a few more that we're hopefully going to line up in June, too. But yeah, you were looking at the 2021-22 version of the MacEwan Youth Jazz Orchestra. That first tune was called Nutville by a jazz luminary and icon named Horace Silver. The person playing the part of Horace Silver on piano was Miranda Pauls. Miranda. And on the original recording, it was also Joe Henderson on tenor, and the man in that shoes was Nathan Thunder right here. All right. I just wanted to explain a little bit about the ensemble. So these are all high school age musicians. They're grade 10 to 12, and they come from across the city, across school districts too. And the way the program works, basically, it was designed by Craig Brennan here, who's on faculty. He's the head of Windsor Brass. He's also technically my boss. it was him and also my old dear friend Marty Majorowicz and colleague. They combined forces and they started this as a way to connect MacEwan and the music community here to the broader Edmonton music community as well, especially with band teachers and in the education system. So if you have a student that's interested in this band, there are some prereqs to get in, but you got to be a member in your high school band program. We don't like taking away. We always want to collaborate with band teachers. And you need to recommend from your band teacher, and you got to show up on Wednesday nights. All right, so that's what all these ones here do. So it's been challenging, of course, with the pandemic this year, but we're really grateful to get a chance to do this for you tonight. Our next tune we're going to do is one called Kogi, and it's by this composer in LA named Jacob Mann. You probably don't know him, but I know a lot of kids around MacEwan seem to know Jacob Mann. Yeah, and now everyone in this band seems to love Jacob Mann too. So if there's no one that likes him, no one's told me yet. They've kept it to themselves. So here we go with Kogi.
Thank you.
That was Jake Pertula on trombone, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, Jake. So this next song, it really doesn't need an introduction, but I have a little anecdote for it. Usually with this band, what we do is I just throw tons of music at them in the fall term, and then we see what we play. We don't do everything, but lots of reading, just always new music, and then we ditch all of it, and then we do a bunch of new stuff for the winter term. But this song, I had a band mutiny. They would not let me actually take this back. We're in December, like, okay, I need this tune back, and they were like, no, no. They refused to give it. They love this one so much. So even if they just wanted to jam and play it at rehearsal, seems to be one that's dear to all of them. This is Haitian Fight Song by Charlie Mingus, and it's going to feature a bunch of people in the band. I don't know, maybe it's like the energy of youth or something. You'll probably hear what I'm talking about if you don't know the song, but yeah, they just all seem to like it. High school kids always love playing this music. So it's going to feature... in the role of Charlie Mingus himself, Sandra Nevesinic on bass. And on val trombone, we have Charlotte Thompson. And we have on trumpet, also Natasha Karnachar. And Byrne McMullen on alto saxophone. And we're going to have Jack Letwin as well on Barry. And last but not least, there's a certain gentleman on the stage that doesn't have a black shirt on. And this is because he has saved us. Usually we have Tony Camerino, that's our tenor player. Unfortunately, he had an emergency and was not able to be here. So this fine young gentleman is helping us out tonight. He just got the music yesterday. So thank you, Jacob. You're going to hear a bit from him as well. So here we go, Haitian Fight Song. Thank you. to introduce the trombone section. That was the trombones. I think that song also needs no introduction, but for those of you that don't know it, that was a song by Miles Davis and Gil Evans called Boplicity. It featured in the role of Miles Davis, Natasha Carniture. Yeah. This song is originally from 1949, that's when it was recorded. It's from a very seminal jazz recording called The Birth of the Cool. A big part of this also is to give them some jazz history and a bit of the legacy of the music and how it evolved over the course of the 20th century especially. So we also try and play some of jazz's greatest hits. In the role of Jerry Mulligan, we had Jack Letwin on baritone saxophone. I just almost called him Jacob, sorry. And in the role of John Lewis here on the piano, we had Miranda Pauls. For this song, just because of how important it is to you, all the solos were actually transcribed, and so they were the original ones as played by the performers on the first recording. We have one more song for you. Gone so soon. this last one, full disclosure, I just picked it because I like it. This is for me. This tune first came out in 1961. It's by a man named Oliver Nelson, who is a really important tenor saxophonist, but also really important in terms of composition. He actually made more of a name for himself in L.A., in the 60s and the 70s as a film score writer. But before he did that, he wrote this tune. It's called Yearning. and it features a bunch more people as well. It's like a kind of, it's a gospel jazz tune, I guess, but because we're almost done now, I want to introduce the whole band to you as well. So you heard Miranda on piano, Miranda Pauls. Sandra Nevesnik on bass. And our drummer, you've been hearing Nathan Zeller all night. Yeah, Nathan. Trumpets, we have Amelia Johnson. And Natasha Karnachar. Adam Dirschnabel. Ingrid Sinkson. And Victoria Haggerty. Our trombone section, we have Michael Pugh. We got Jake Pertula, Charlotte Thompson, and we have Julia Hawkinson and Tori Greening. And on saxophones, we got Jacob. You know Jacob. We also have a new sub for the band. We've been missing some people. It's been really tough this term. People have been sick. I was out for a while, too. That didn't help. But we have this great young musician from McNally. This is Kurt Villeray, who is subbing in for us tonight. He also just got the music a couple days ago. So thank you, Kurt. We got Bern McMullen on alto, too. Nathan Thunder and Jack Letwin. I just wanted to say thanks again to the big band here at school for hosting us. We really appreciate that we had a chance to share the bill with you, and we hope we can do it again in the future. Thanks, Ray. Thanks to Craig. Thanks to everyone that's here on staff in the music department that helps to make these things possible. So, and also thanks to all of you, to the band teachers in the audience. Are there any band teachers? Put your hands up. Where are the band teachers? It's hard to see. But thank you to the band teachers, and thank you to all of you, to families and friends, for supporting everyone in their efforts to grow in music. So, all right, here's Yearning. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. Please, please stick around for the second set with the MacEwan University Big Band. Thanks.
Welcome back. That was a piece called Zinc Bar, again written by Antti Riisinen from Finland, and it featured on the piano Roman de Bruyl, and on the trumpet Eric Flores Moreno. Welcome back, as I said, and thank you. Let's put our hands again together for the MacEwan Youth Jazz Orchestra. Jared talked about some of the challenges that this year has had. The first year of COVID, I think we're all thinking, okay, well, it's going to end soon, so everything will be fine. We'll just make it through this, and we'll just push through. And then we got to the second year, it was like, oh. And things changed. Of course, some of the rules changed, some of the things loosened up, and you had people kind of coming and going because people got sick. And of course, the most important thing was to make sure that people isolated when that happened. So there was a lot of, I'm a relatively inflexible person, as many know, but I've had to learn how to be very flexible and sort of kind of go with the flow. And actually, I think it's good. The medications have helped a lot, the fact is that it's been one of those years where we've had to really work together and make sure that things work out and still ensure a really good performance experience for everybody. And I think that's when you come to music school, especially for many of these who are in performance, if you take away the performance, it sort of begs some questions about going to music school and performance. So I think what we did is we've been able to protect it for 2 years and ensure that the students still got a great opportunity to perform and get out there and play. And they've had many, many experiences, not the least of which is a concert before Christmas, convocation before Christmas, which we had to do for the fall convocation. With this concert, in about 3 weeks, we do a convocation for all the alumni over the last 2 years who never got an opportunity to graduate. Going across the stage, so we're going to be doing that on the 28th. And then this is our 50th year as MacEwan, originally Grant MacEwan Community College and now MacEwan University. So we celebrate 50 years, and of course this group are doing the 50th anniversary celebration on April 29th. And then just when you think that's over, then we take 2 months off, and then we come back and do convocation in June. And just when you think that's over, then we start rehearsals in July for next year. And then there's lots of sectionals and things like that. Anyways, they'll love it. Our next piece that we're going to play for you, this concert, I always try to be fairly eclectic. That's always the case. So there's some swing, there's some straight eighth fusion, there's funk, there's Latin, there's everything. This next piece of music is called New Boss. It's written by John Moss, who, of course, you don't know. But he wrote a lot of music, actually, for concert band as well. But he was also a really good friend of the previous director of the MacEwan University Big Band back in the mid-80s, Rick Garn, who was the head of winds at that time. And John Moss wrote a piece called New Boss. I just don't think he had a very great idea of what to call it, so he just called it another New Boss. And it was one of the very first pieces I played when I was with the group in those days, as coming out of university at the time. And then in 2004, we also recorded it on our recording. But this is New Bossa, and I won't say anything more. It features, actually, on the trombone, I guess I will say something more, Noah New. And I'm really, really glad that I had the opportunity to have Noah in the band this year. Noah was one of those students 2 years ago who never got a chance to do a final recital because of COVID. And Noah's been back with us playing trombone and leading the section and giving his expertise to that group. And so this one features on the trombone alumni graduate, Noah New.
Thank you.
again, no one knew. Introducing my saxophone section, you've been introduced to a few times already, Jacob Rabuka on tenor saxophone. Mitchell Prentice on the alto saxophone. Featured on soprano saxophone and my lead alto, this is Holly Sangster. Nathan Sedano. And Aiden Schaefer on baritone saxophone. This next piece of music was a commission that was done for a faculty, actually for the opening of this particular hall. The very first concert we did, we had people write music and arrangements for it, and we have some great writers and arrangers and teachers and faculty in our department. And two people, one person who actually sang with this band many, many years ago, literally many, many years ago, Shandell Rimmer, wrote this piece along with pianist Tom Van Cedars, and I know that Tom is here because I saw him walking into the building. So thank you for being here this evening with us. But it's called Exhale, and it's a great piece of music. It features the trombone section at one point, but it most importantly features our vocalist in the role of Shandell Rimmer, and it also features on guitar Morgan Hanna. This is, and also Roman de Brule doing his very great take on Tom Van Cedars. Check that beard, and man, like that's so, I got the bearded rhythm section. It's like, look at this. I told them they had to shave, but there was, it didn't happen. There you go. But anyways, this is Exhale. Please welcome to the stage, Miranda Smith.
Thank you.
Smith. Roman de Bruyl. And welcome back to the, well, just a little bit of the background here. Alyssa was one of the other students who 2 years ago, unfortunately, like literally the night before her recital, or it was two nights or something like that, it was that close. But yeah, day before. All of a sudden, we got the call that we were shut down, and all students who were just about to present all of their stuff never got that opportunity. So it was really great that she could be back again, and she was a stalwart member of the big band for 4 years, and was a member of my wife's program as well when she was at Wagner School. So I'm really grateful and glad that she could be back with us celebrating a little bit of graduation time and alumni time. And I'm going to welcome her back to the stage to do her next piece. I'll let her talk about it.
All right, I'll keep this one short. This next piece is another by Antti Rissanen. I really like it. It's a little bit different than maybe what we've already heard so far, so it'll be a nice change of pace. It's called Samilainen, or Samian people, I did some research, it's about the indigenous northern people in Finland. So please enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. That also featured no one new on the trombone.
The reason I talk is because they need time to sort of change and also rest their face for a brief moment. You've been introduced to two people in the trombone section already. I will bring your attention to others. So again, we have Noah New, we have Madeline Vanderslice, we have Joseph Zenarosa, and we have Ethan Graves. One of the great big bands of all time was that of none other than Thad Jones. This is called Kids Are Pretty People. Well, I don't know about that.
Thank you.
Alyssa Moore's on the trumpet, Noah New on the trombone. And a very brief solo by Evan Click on the bass. People have to put up with a lot in the trumpet section. My trumpet section, ooh, I'm missing one. On the end, we have Eric Flores Moreno. We have Theo Dlewski, Liam McCrory Wilson, Alyssa Moores, and the one who does all the heavy lifting, we have Liam Shearer. One of our great friends here is a man by the name of Fred Stride. He's a writer arranger from Vancouver, who we have a great relationship. And last summer, the Saskatoon Jazz Orchestra were looking. They were doing a concert of Stevie Wonder pieces, and Dean McNeil came to me and said, "So, do you want to co-commission a piece of music to be arranged by Fred?" And I said, "Absolutely," and we'd like to feature our vocalist on a great Stevie Wonder tune. And there's a few little sort of like little quotes along the way in this that Fred throws in. But please welcome to the stage Miranda Smith to sing Superstition.
Thank you.
Smith. And Nathan the Funk Sedano. A couple thank yous before we get to the last piece. First of all, I'd like to introduce my rhythm section in its entirety now on the piano, Roman de Baril. Guitar, Morgan Hanna. On the bass, Evan Click. And keeping us all honest, James Coomeron. It takes a team to put these things together, and boy, I tell you, the last couple of years, it's taken real teamwork to make all of this work. And we're very fortunate to have the support of our administration here, our chancellor, our new chancellor, which we brought into our university this year, Dr. Tony Fields, our president and vice chancellor, Dr. Annette Trimby, and our provost, Dr. Craig Monk, our faculty, the dean, Dr. Alan Gilliland, our chair of music department, Dr. William Richards, our advisors, Jane Ference, and our advisor, Katie Olson. And our support staff, thank you for making things work here. Andrea Murphy in the box office, Mark Stubbings, who coordinates everything for the front of house. Scotia Wills, also in front of house. Jeff Backus, our theater manager. Our lighting, Morgan Franchi. And our sound, Mike Brazeau. And of course, our stage assistant, Trina Miller. Pardon me. Thank you to all of those people. thing that I think is probably the most important is that it's really the, you know, as much as it's great to stand up here and sort of tell them what pieces they're going to do, you give them choice. This is totally a dictatorship, man. You said you want some feedback. Okay. Say the word dictatorship. He won't do it. Actually, it's the farthest thing from a dictatorship. I think actually everybody contributes, and that's why it works. But please, the round of applause really goes to all these people, so put your hands together for the big band. I'm very lucky because I get to stand in front of a group of people, and I don't really have to worry a lot about notes and rhythms and things like that. What we can really do is get down to sort of nuance and talking about music and how it comes together. And that's a great privilege that I've been fortunate to be part of for 38 years, which is a long time. And hopefully we can do it again next year. I'm looking forward to it. As I said, we've got performances still coming up. I want to thank our friends over in Finland at the Metropolia University who provided us with some charts this evening And we did reciprocated with that earlier this year. It's a great thing, and I hope that we can start to do things more like that. And of course, the more things we can do with our friends in the front row here in the Maijo group, the better. So thank you for all of you for being here this evening. And of course, it's so good to, last year we did performances to nobody. We did them to cameras. And by the way, I want to thank Dylan Cave, who I think is somewhere back there doing all the video. There he is, there's the hand. There we go. So we still do have a live stream going of this, but last year all we had was live stream. And it's really interesting, like when you finish a piece of music and it's dead silent. It's very weird. That's all I can say. But it's so nice to have people back, because music is meant to be played with an audience and it's meant to be experienced. All the great moments, some of the challenges that we run into, but it's most important that we have people here listening and supporting each other in this endeavor. So thank you to all of you for being here, and we look forward to seeing you next fall again for our next series. We hope that you have the very best of the spring and the summer, and we'll be around, so please come and join us. Our last piece that we're going to do for you today, you know, you'd think I know this, but apparently I don't. Yeah. It's called Zinc Bar. I want to know what the Zinc Bar is, but it's somewhere in Finland. We're going to go with that. And it's written, again, by Antti Riisinen. And what? That's your place.
I got something to say.
Oh. And anyways, this one will feature on the trumpet Liam Shearer.
I think there was one more person we needed to thank tonight, Mr. Ray Baril. He's truly been through a... Thank you. He's been through a lot to have us playing up here. He's always advocated for us and for the music program, and especially the last 2 years, he's done a ton of work to keep us here. So we are so, so grateful, Ray. Thank you.
Piece. Thank you very much to the band. Thank you to all of you. This is Solo Flight.
Drum.
Liam Shearer on the trumpet, Jacob Rabuka on the tenor saxophone. Thank you very much, everybody. We'll see you soon.